Hey, everybody, guess what? This guy needs no introduction, but I'm going to introduce him anyway. Scott Hamilton, my friend, it's
Hi.
been a
Yay.
minute since we've seen
It's
each
been a
other.
minute. I know this like this crazy period that we've gone through, and I'm hoping that we're able to endure it to the end and everybody stays healthy and we can get back to whatever the next normal is, so it's been a wild time and it's been tragic for a lot of people. We're just trying to get our work done as well, trying to solve another problem that's affecting even more. It's hard to believe even more people. It's been crazy just to try to continue to research cancer in a pandemic. It feels like the bandwidth is on one side, and so we've had our challenges, but we got through 2020 really well, and we're really looking forward to ending 2021 really good. So I'm excited about the possibilities of this fall.
Yeah, I want to talk about a couple of things. First, I want to say, because I haven't seen you in a while, but I just noticed I just missed your birthday. So happy birthday.
Ah, I know, it's great. It's just the outcome is kind of a surprise, and with my health history, it's kind of fun just to. Okay, here we have. I was given another trip around the sun. Okay, here we go. Next one, rock and roll.
So, do you have any family traditions for your birthday? Because I feel like some people with their families do different things. Sometimes it's.
Usually, it's we go to we like to go to one restaurant in particular, and do I do that on this? I'm not sure if that's allowed or if
Well,
it's even. I
yeah,
mean,
you can
okay,
say.
well we. I really love going to Sperry's in Cool Springs. It's just, it's good food and I love the salad bar and it's just a cool vibe. And we're able to, kind of everybody, all my kids, love it there. And I always kind of splurge on the peppermint stick ice cream. So it's kind of like that's been one family tradition. But generally, when my kids were younger, I called it giving my birthday away. And I would always like, okay, everybody, we're going on my birthday. We're all going to get bikes today. So we go to a bike shop and we buy bicycles. Or, okay, on my birthday today, we're going to do this for you. So it was really fun, those years that we're able to kind of say, okay, it's my birthday. So you can get excited about it because you're going to get something out of this, right?
I
Because
like
not really.
that. That's a great.
It's called giving your birthday away. And it's really fun to, just sort of let your kids get excited about, they're going to get something, a really nice present on your birthday. So
Make
it's
them
really
excited
fun.
to celebrate you,
Yeah.
right? In
Oh
a way.
yeah. And they can't wait for it, and then it may amount to bribery on a small way, but who knows? It's just a
We
fun way
won't
to
call it
celebrate
that.
life. Now you celebrate life,
Exactly. Which,
there's another year. Here's another opportunity. Let's have some fun.
yeah. Another thing I want to mention, which I want to say congratulations to you. You got the Kiwanis Outstanding Nashvillian of the Year.
Yeah, it was really
Wow.
fun. It was really a great luncheon, and it's just an honor, to see the past recipients. It was really, surreal to be now included in that list. And I told when I accepted, which was really, it was a fun luncheon. And when I accepted it, I was like, this is kind of how I felt like when I won my first world figure skating title. I was standing on the podium and I was thinking, this must be the lowest place in figure skating history if I'm its champion. If I'm the Nashvillian of the year, you guys probably lowered the bar quite a bit, but they were really kind. They said I could win it every year, and I love Nashville and I'll can, I love everything about Nashville. I love the people here. I love all the amenities. It's my favorite airport in the country, and it's a great place to raise family. Schools are good. There's just lots of things to do here, and it's centrally located. I mean, I love Nashville, so the fact that I get to live, work, and try to change the world a little bit for the better in Nashville, it just feels so natural and so organic and also really well supported.
Yeah, well, I wanted to mention that. Congratulations on that. You've kind of mentioned about living and working and doing events here. Let's talk about that. You have an event coming up, November 21st, Scott
Yeah.
Hamilton and friends at Bridgestone Arena. So how many years is this now?
Well, this is five. We got interrupted last year. We did sort of a house event because everything was kind of shut down. So
Right.
this year we're bringing the live music and skating show back, and this one is truly it's unique. I mean, this is the 26th show of this kind that I produced over the years, and this one's remarkably different. Last year, it was a little, well, over a year ago, Pete Fisher asked me to reach out to a friend of his named Michael Busby, who is an incredible songwriter producer. He
Yes.
was diagnosed with brain cancer, and from diagnosis to succumbing was 9 weeks and one day. In fact, today is the first anniversary of his passing. And so Pete thought it would be a really great thing to, since glioblastoma multiforme brain cancer has got limited research, and we really don't like bullies. I've never liked bullies. Being the littlest one in my class, I really haven't liked bullies in a long time. But this one's a big, nasty, terrible bully with really no survival. And so it's actually been knocking on our door all year with an earlier fundraiser we did. The gentleman with glioblastoma rode the entire length of the Natchez Trace on a bicycle to raise money for cancer, which knocked me down in a big way. And then Michael Busby, when he passed, we just felt like we had to do something profound. And so this year is the first year we've ever dedicated the show to someone. And his wife, Jessie, has been an incredible partner. And the artists are coming out that he worked with to pay tribute to him. It's Lady A and Maren Morris and For King and Country and Grace Potter. My goodness, a rock star, Grace Potter.
I saw
And
that.
then my friend Cece Winans is going to come out as well and really bless us. So it's going to be a really rich night of music and skating and a celebration of life and of a specific life. And we really want to honor him, his music, his talent, and the people that he's touched, and really give his family something special that, we're gathering around them, and we're kind of doing this amazing thing together to change the outcome for people in the future diagnosed with this horrific form of cancer. So we're working hard, harder than we've ever worked, in our time of uncertainty and craziness. And I'm really hopeful that we can, get through 2021 and get some momentum into the next few years to grow the foundation even bigger and touch more people in a more profound way.
Yeah, I'm glad that you guys are doing that. I know last year they weren't able to really do a whole lot with his passing, and he is an incredible songwriter, producer, has helped some really big artists in the Nashville area. So I appreciate that you guys are being able to do that this year.
Oh, and his wife Jessie is lovely, and she just really wants to do everything she can to make this event successful with us. So I couldn't be more blessed and honored to partner with her, and she's the three beautiful little girls. Oh my goodness. So Busby is he's special, and Nashville. One cool thing I love, especially about country music and Nashville, is it's not like it's all about the next, the next, the next. It is, but no one gets left behind. When you look at the Grand Ole Opry and you look at the people on that stage, and it's just, the entire music industry is celebrated, and whatever your accomplishments are, they continue on into the next and the next and the next, and they celebrate their history and their legacy. And it's really wonderful to see that happening. And so for a show like ours to really want to highlight someone's career and celebrate their achievements while also funding a solution to the, what took them from us, it just feels like Nashville is the best place, the perfect place for that.
Yeah. You're also combining skating, which is near and dear to your heart. And I was looking through the list. So I'm not as familiar with some of these skaters, but I know that the Olympics are next year, February 2022.
Yeah, in January, the Olympic figure skating team will be announced here in Nashville. We're hosting the U.S. Figure Skating Championships in January from, I think it's from the 3rd to the 9th, something like that. Anyway, Nashville has become a hotbed for figure skating. I don't know how that happened, but it has just become this really cool place. And the skaters we have coming are national, world, Olympic champions. And to see skating, we turn Bridgestone into a theater, basically. We take the glass out, and then we cover the boards, and we put seats in front of them. So everything is raked all the way down. And you know, while we're doing this, I just want to, you know, big shout out to Sean Henry and his team, you know, especially Sean and his generosity for allowing us to gift us the building for this event. And their generosity is really incredible. And, you know, in a building that's the number two busiest building in the United States and sixth in the world, for them to gift us the building for this event is amazing. And my partnership with them and the, you know, skating academies and Learn to Skate has been really wonderful. And it's been a great highlight in my life. So, you know, thank you, Sean Henry, David Kells and his team for really allowing us to be even more successful in our pursuits, because, you know, they just took a gigantic line item and just, you know, pushed it away.
Yeah. Well, tell me about some of the skaters that you're looking forward. I didn't get a chance to go through all the lists. Are any of these guys going to be in the Olympics in 2020?
No, these are all professional skaters. They've all done their Olympic time, and now they've expanded their capacities to entertain and to perform and do all kinds of different things. So to put an amateur skater in, you know, I have in the past, and it's been really fun, but there's a marked difference because their focus is so on competitive skating that they're only thinking about what they're doing on the ice. Now with these pros, you know, you got Jeremy Abbott, who I never want to do a show. He's a four-time U.S. champion and like, you know, so gifted and so artistic. Elijah Baldea is coming for the first time, and he's kind of like a internet sensation with his skating and his activism and everything else. It's the first time he's joined us, which is cool. Katya Gordieva at 50 years old said, "Oh, I need to get in shape. Of course I'll be there," you know? And then Gracie Gold is joining us for the first time, and that'll be fun. And we have Ilya Kulik, Olympic champion, is joining us as well. And Caitlin Osmond, a world champion, Olympic medalist, Olympic gold medalist, actually. And, you know, you've got all this, Jeff Buttle and Ryan Bradley, who's certifiably crazy, the stuff that he does to go upside down and, you know, all the other ways. And it's really cool to see Alyssa Sisney, of course. And then Megha Duhamel, who was here last time with her partner, Eric Radford. They, you know, it's very, you know, soap opera-esque, where he found another partner because she was having children. And so she says, "Well, I'm just going to find another partner." So she's coming with her new partner, Dylan Moskovich, who's a Canadian Olympian, and Caitlin Weaver and Andrew Poggé, who are just, I mean, like the definition of gorgeous on the ice. And so, yeah, we've got a lot of great skaters, an incredible set list, you know, with these iconic music artists, and it's just such a blessing to be able to do these types of events to wow people and to entertain them while we're doing good in the community. And for those who haven't seen skating live before, and especially this show because of the live music and the fact that you're on the ice or really much
really
closer
close.
To it than you
in a hockey game,
it's jaw-dropping how spectacular it is. So we're really hoping to turn, some of the turnstiles a little bit, you know, this year more than we ever have. And we've increased our marketing, and we're really hoping to, you know, get people excited about coming out and solving a problem. I mean, you think of it, you just take a step back and you think of 69 people an hour in this country die of cancer.
Wow.
Each one of those is a devastating loss. Every one of those. So when you multiply that, like, you know, times 1,660 a day. You can't imagine the devastation that's happening in people's lives, their families, their loved ones. It's like my mom lost her battle to cancer 44 years ago last May. And there's not a day I don't think of her, talk about her. And there's not a day I don't have gratitude for the fact that she was my mom, right? So, you know, it's that. That's the fuel for the fire that keeps us going. I lost my mom to cancer and I became a fundraiser. I survived cancer and I became an activist, you know? So I really want to change the way people are treated for cancer forever. And, you know, we partner with phenomenal like-minded institutions. So, you know, we kind of lighten the load, you know, all ships rise with the tide. And this year it just feels like, you know, glioblastoma multiforme has been knocking on our door. And I don't believe in coincidences, only God's scheduled opportunities. So I really believe that this is something that we need to be focusing on and changing forever.
Yeah. Well, we appreciate all that you do for that. This event is amazing. If people haven't been, I'm going to put the link in here for tickets. Tickets are on sale now. Can you believe it? They're already on sale. I just looked. I think you've already sold some tickets already. I'm going to put that link right here while we're talking so people can have that.
So if you know, businesses are out there, if people want to come on and still and sponsor the show and you know, come to the dinner afterwards, because that's part of the, if you come to the show as a sponsor and you buy a table at the dinner, you get preferred seating, all that stuff. Anyway, so we're still looking for sponsorship. We really want to make this year a big year, impactful year. And we still have sponsorship slots available. And for those, you can go to scottcares.org and ask for Carrie Morgan, my executive director, and she'll be happy to take your order form. So, you know, again, it's with all the, what has been a period of uncertainty, we're coming through that now. I think COVID has, you know, become, you know, the devil we know in so many regards. And I think, you know, Bridgestone Arena will be packed out for the Predator game. So I think that, you know, we can do this for cancer as well. And I want people to feel good about coming and whatever the regulations or considerations that Bridgestone Arena will be putting down for safety for their customers, will be respecting those as well. So come join us. Let's change cancer forever. Let's save lives and have a really great time doing it.
Yeah, it's a great time. You guys go check it out. I love that you brought together your two passions, skating and helping support cancer. So,
and I love music.
Oh, and music. I mean, you've got some of the incredible artists. So, wow. It's going to be
great. The set list is going to be insane, especially when we open and close the show. Yeah, it's going to be, people are going to be inspired. And it's going to be a powerful night.
Well, I tell you what, Grace Potter can rock the house. If you need to get people going, Grace Potter will get you on your feet.
Yes, she will. And
CC Whitings is going to make you cry.
Well, she'll definitely just, you'll be looking up, you know, it's just, man, I love Cece. And, you know, anytime that we visited her church, you know, and when she gets on stage, that worship just sort of like goes to 11. If you remember the old Spinal Tap reference, it's like, you know, it's hovering around 9, 10. And when she steps up there, it goes to like 11, 12. So she's a remarkable, amazing voice artist, inspiring, like all get out. And there's going to be some really powerful moments in the show that will really, you know, just really remind people, you know, how impactful and powerful their lives can be just by participating in this event. So we're excited.
Yeah. Well, thanks again. It's so great to see you. Congratulations on all your things you're doing. Maybe we'll have to come back and talk about the Olympics. Will you be involved this year? Next year. It's actually next year.
I think all the criteria with China and like, you know, all those pieces and where they put everything. It's in Beijing this year.
Yeah.
Of all places. So, well, I'm under contract to go, but it just, you know, I don't know how it's all going to work because the rules, everything keeps changing. So, I've been to every Olympics since 1992. So I hate to miss this one, but you know, I got family to take care of too. So
yeah,
we'll figure that out.
Okay, well, we'll check back in and see how that works out. But still, even if you don't get to go, I would love to get your perspective because that is a big deal, the Olympics.
It's the biggest deal for any skater out there. It's lifelong. It whatever happens at the Olympics tends to feed into whatever this is next, and in a really positive and profound way. So, we wouldn't be talking right now and I not competed at the Olympics.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's just that. How many years later? 37. So,
Wow,
37.
I can't believe
Yeah.
that. It
Isn't that
doesn't seem like that
crazy?
at all.
I was
Wow.
in diapers, or, you know, I must have been.
You were a toddler. They're like, go skate. Bring home the gold. Hey, thanks again, you guys. I put the link up there. Go get your tickets before they sell out. They just went on sale, I think, the end of last week. So you get your best pick of the seats real
Oh
close.
yeah, and you know we made sure that it's like a concert. There's no bad seat, right? So people will be able to see the artists, see the skaters, you know, up close because we do it all with camera assist and the big projectors. So it's going to feel intimate no matter where you sit. But you know, come out and let's celebrate life and let's do a good thing for the next person that's diagnosed with this horrible disease.
Yeah. All right. Thanks again. We'll see you guys
All
soon.
right.
Bye,
Good to see you.
everybody.
Yeah.